So our previous power series solution was successive derivatives. So this will be using undetermined coefficients. So there's a little theory that you have to have here. And basically, you need to know that this power series will exist. And if it exists, then you can start taking derivatives of it and look at the way the derivatives are related. So I'm going to sort of skip the assumptions and just start with write down the problem, and I'll write down what the solution is going to look like, and then you're going to figure out the first few coefficients. So we're going to solve y double prime minus x plus 1 y prime plus x squared y equals x. This seems like the one we solved before. That's okay. We'll solve it in a different way. So our initial conditions, y of 0 equals 1, y prime of 0 also equals 1. Okay, so we should get the same solution. We're going to get it in a slightly different way. So we're going to assume that there is an analytic solution. So assume there is a solution to this, and it has a power series representation. So that's what it means to be analytic. So the power series is going to look like a 0 plus a 1. We are centered, just looking at the initial conditions, we're going to be centered at x equals 0. So if you don't have x equals 0 inside your interval of convergence, you can't use these initial conditions. So right here, we're going to be centered at, I think we're using the letter A. It's either A or X naught, I think. So we're centered at A equals 0. That was determined by the fact that we needed to use 0 here. So it's A1 X minus 0 plus A2 X minus 0 squared A3 X cubed plus dot, dot, dot. So what I want you to do is figure out what are the values for A0, A1, A2, and A3. And of course, we could go further than that, but we're just going to get the first four coefficients. So write down, so here's y of x. Write down y prime of x and y double prime of x. And actually, I'm going to move this centered at a equals 0 over. So I can write down a couple more terms. So probably the biggest pain will be multiplying y prime by x plus 1. That's going to be, you've got to sort of distribute, or foiling is the wrong word, but either to multiply all the terms across all the other terms. So that product's going to be the annoying product to compute right there. So you're just finding two derivatives and then plugging those in. And then you're going to look at a powers of x, basically.